What's good, everybody? Welcome to the Pull Up and Chat. My name is BJ Matthews, aka BJ. Before we get started, follow me on my YouTube page, Pull Up Basketball Podcast, Spotify, the Pull Up Basketball Podcast. Continue to like, share, and subscribe me and my boys' videos on YouTube and Spotify. Follow him on his Instagram page, Rick Master at RickMaster23. Follow him on his Facebook page, Roger Masters. Again, continue to like, share, subscribe, updated content. We have our shows every weekend at 9 o'clock on Sundays. You know what I'm saying? We upload videos weekly on YouTube. So we appreciate all the love and support that we're getting. But let's get into it. So, you know, we got the NBA season just kicking off in about 10 days on the 19th, so we're very excited. So what I chose to do, I did with somewhat of a poll. You know, most improved player, most valuable player, defensive player of the year award, teams to watch, you know what I'm saying, the NBA finals matchups and stuff of that nature. So, and I did the poll this morning, of course. So I had to make this video, you know, pretty detailed, you know, a subject that I think people are still getting lost in the sauce with. So I had a discussion with two people last night about my polls when it came to the Clippers. Now, I don't know if people are just not paying attention or people are just trying to refuse to accept what's going on. I don't know what it is. But we just went through this last year. And I don't know, when I say the Clippers, for some reason people cringe. Like I said, they'll win the NBA champ. They'll win the Western Conference Finals with Kawhi there, because of the deepest team in the league. And people still get uncomfortable. I don't know why, but it's just like they proved it in the playoffs last season. They're the deepest team in the league. And I want to get to, you know, into something else going with Kawhi. This notion that he can't be the top player in the league, I'm still not understanding why. And people, when I ask them, you know, why can't you put Kawhi Leonard in the top position, like the best player in the league, they always run back to the same thing, load management. Now, this is why I have to say you have to make up your mind. What are you going to tell? Are you going to put Kawhi as a top five player? Do we say that he's a top five player or is he not? Because there's another player by the name of Anthony Davis who's as injury as prone as Kawhi Leonard is. But yet, year after year, we keep giving him a pass. We keep saying Anthony Davis could be this, could be that, could be a top five player, could be the best player in the league if he's healthy. Now, this is the same Anthony Davis when he was in New Orleans, didn't do nothing, didn't take his team to a title. This is the same Anthony Davis whose body is made out of pure glass. This is the same Anthony Davis who year after year after year, we have to keep saying he needs to be more aggressive. He needs to be more assertive. Anthony Davis needs to be more of an alpha. Anthony Davis needs to take the reins over from LeBron James. He always needs a kick in the ass to get going. Excuse my French. He always needs to get a kick in the butt to wake up. Top five players don't need a kick. Steph Curry, LeBron, Giannis, Kawhi, KD don't need a kick. They roll out of bed ready to play. I don't have to keep telling you to be ready to hoop. One game you're being dominant, you know what I'm saying, being dominant in the paint. The next game you're shooting outside threes. I don't consider you a top five player, and I'm not going to keep looking at the glass half full. But that's what we keep doing with Anthony Davis. Anthony Davis got next. Anthony Davis, PER king. Anthony Davis being 6'10", can dribble and shoot the ball. But yet, Anthony Davis needs to get checked game in and game out. We keep talking about Kawhi Leonard is injury prone and he has low management issues. He's only had two real injuries. And that was the Spurs in 2018. That was last year with the Lake, with the Clippers. Other than that, he hasn't had no real big injuries. Year after year, he plays up to 70% of the games. My whole thing is, look, with low management, this is my whole thing, my opinion. As long as you play up to 70-75% of your games, that's enough data to come up with a conclusion, an intelligent conclusion. But for some reason, when I say Kawhi Leonard is the best player in the NBA because of this reason, people think I'm crazy. Or people think, oh, BJ, you're being delusional. BJ, you're being a lover of Kawhi. BJ, you don't know. They don't say I don't know what I'm talking about. But they just act like, they look at me like I'm side-eye. Like, I don't know, like it hurts their feelings. I don't know what it is. This dude is the best two-way player in the NBA. He's the most winningest. He has the highest winning percentage out of anybody in the top 10 in the playoffs. He's the only dude in the league that can give you 30 points in a playoff game and also play against your top player and defend him on the other end. The only three wings that's ever been able to do that is Michael Jordan, Kobe, and LeBron, who's able to give you 30 and able to defend your play, the best team's player the entire game. Now, I ask, okay, who do you put over Kawhi Leonard if you don't think he's the best player in the league? Who are you putting over him? they start doing the stuttering. KD. Giannis. Steph. Oh yeah, that's right, Steph Curry. And I'm like, nah, wrong. First of all, Steph Curry, no. Steph Curry, as great as he is on the offensive side of the floor, he's a little guard. He cannot play defense and shut down the opposing team's best player. He's the most offensive impactful player on in the NBA. And what Steph Curry is able to do is monumental. But the rules of basketball is you're going to choose a bigger player over a smaller player. And Steph Curry cannot do what Kawhi Leonard can do on both sides of the ball. Is Steph Curry a better shooter than Kawhi? Obviously. Is Steph Curry more of a facilitator than Kawhi? Obviously. But if I'm talking about a full impact of both sides of the ball in the entire game, I'm giving it to Kawhi Leonard easily. That's why it's so easy for me to pick him over Steph Curry. Now, Giannis Antetokounmpo, here's my thing. I get it. You won the championship. The team won the championship last year. But I need to see that you're able to do this when everybody is healthy. Jamal Murray, Anthony Davis, Kawhi Leonard, Kyrie Irving, James Harden, which, by the way, Giannis is responsible for Kyrie Irving getting hurt last year, sticking his foot out in the playoffs. I need to see what you do against those guys when they're ready to play. Now, if you do this year again, okay, you got me. But just before the Bucks won last season against the Nets, people were talking about Giannis Antetokounmpo, like he needs to be with LeBron James because he's not even a first option. But now since he's benefited from injuries and people being hurt, oh, we got to put him as the best player in the league. I don't operate like that. Is Giannis not top five? He is. But I'm not putting him over KD, and I'm not putting him over Kawhi, which brings me to KD. Now, if you want to say KD's better than Kawhi Leonard, have at it. You know what I'm saying? What he did in the playoffs was monumental. KD has played his dues. KD has two championships, multiple scoring titles, finals MVP, all that great stuff, right? If you want to say KD's better than Kawhi, fine. But he's the only person that I'm putting over him right at this point in his career. And I will still take Kawhi over KD for this simple reason. Because what he brings on both sides of the ball, and the gap between KD and Kawhi is greater from KD's defense or Kawhi's defense to KD's offense than it is from Kawhi's offense to Kawhi's offense to KD's offense. Kawhi can still give you 30 plus in the playoffs. KD will give you 30 plus. But the defensive parity that Kawhi has from KD is way more farther in gap. Kawhi is a two-time defensive player of the year. That's how great this dude is on the defensive side of the ball. KD doesn't guard the best player throughout the entire game. He focuses solely on offense. But get back to my point with the Clippers. I don't know what it is that people are still walking around pressure on. We just went through this last season. I was very, very consistent what I was saying with the Clippers, that they were the deepest team in the league. And they proved that so much that without three of their starters throughout the entire playoffs, they was able to accomplish what they were able to accomplish. They beat the number one team in the NBA record-wise, season-wise, in the Utah Jazz. And then they go against the Phoenix Suns, who really just ran out of gas and took them to six games. And this notion, and I'm going to get to another point, this notion that the Lakers were better than the Clippers and have been is no, they're not. The Clippers are a fully better team. The Clippers went and came back with their same team from last season because they believe they can win a championship with the team. The Lakers recycled everybody from KCP, Kyle Kuzma, Alex Caruso, Montrezl Harrell, Marc Gasol. They took six guys off their roster, and they recycled new pieces in hopes that they're able to gel fast enough for the playoffs this season. That team last year was not better than Phoenix. The Phoenix Suns were a better team than the Lakers. So even if Anthony Davis came back, the Lakers were not a better team. Now, I know that may cut off a lot of people's heads, but that's what it is. And shout out to my boy Kobe, you know what I'm saying? My greatest player of all time. My opinion, my favorite player of all time. But no, the Lakers are not better than the Clippers. The Clippers are a deeper team. They have a better coach. And Kawhi is a better player than LeBron James at this point of his career. And that's another thing. Stop saying LeBron is the best player in the league. That's out. That's why he needs more assistance from other players, bringing in a Westbrook and all these players to recycle to help him out, which is fine because he's 36 years old. He can't do what he used to do on both sides of the ball anymore. So he's not a better than Kawhi Leonard. He's not better than Kevin Durant. He's not better than Giannis Antetokounmpo. But going back to my point, the Clippers, people are still sleepwalking. I don't know what it is. I don't know if the Clippers have to win a championship to see how good Kawhi Leonard is. I think that's what they have to do, because this dude won two championships has two Defensive Player of the Years, has two Finals MVPs. But for some reason, I'm feeling like Anthony Davis gets more of the benefit of the doubt than Kawhi Leonard gets, because we keep hearing about what the Anthony Davis could be. But Kawhi, for some reason, we got to keep hearing stuff about he's low management, he's not a leader, he's not this, that, and the other. Now, mind you, Kawhi just took a team that's never won a championship in the Toronto Raptors to a championship just a couple years ago. And that seems to get credit to Kyle Lowry for some reason, even though Kyle Lowry is, you know, a borderline all-star. He never won nothing until Kawhi Leonard got there, and he hasn't won ever since he left. But for some reason, he was the reason why the Raptors won the championship, because he was the leader of the team. The narrative that's been put out there about Kawhi since he left Toronto and, you know, went to the Clippers, for some reason, he's not well-liked. And I don't know why, because he doesn't talk to nobody. You can't find nothing about him unless you talk to his Uncle Dennis. He doesn't go with the media. He comes to work and plays and goes to practice and goes home. So I don't know what you can't like about the dude. And more people, you probably should start, you know, following the Clippers a little bit, because you might actually like the team. Because if you're a real fan of hoop, then you can respect the way they play, because they play with a lot of heart, grit, and toughness, and they don't give up. So, again, I'm saying it, Kawhi is the best player in the NBA when healthy, for those simple reasons. And if you don't think he is, give me a real back and forth dialogue discussion to explain why. Because I'm getting a lot of, you know, run around. I'm not getting what the real point is. I just put the poll up and I said the Lakers will win the championship if Kawhi's not there. And most people said yes. But when I say Kawhi is there with the Clippers, that most people are saying they can't win the championship. So I'm like, people are still not, I don't know, people are not getting it. The Clippers are a better built team than the Lakers. So it is what it is, but everybody has an opinion. Continue to like, share, and subscribe our videos on, you know, YouTube, the Pull Up Basketball Podcast, Spotify, the Pull Up Basketball Podcast. Pull up your seat, pull up a chair, pull up. Peace. Out of here like swimwear.